Join us for this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, where myself and PC are going to take you into Bicep and the awesome new extension in Visual Studio. So tune in. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the latest episode of the DevOps Lab. With us this week, we have a very special guest, PC. PC, welcome.
Hi, April.
I'm very excited to have you here. And, you know, unfortunately, we can't be together in the same room, but we're here together on the DevOps Lab to talk about some cool stuff today. Before we get started, can you tell everyone what it is you do at Microsoft?
Sure, April. Yeah, first of all, I want to thank you for having me today. It's great to be here and very excited to show off what my team has been working on. So I am a PM in the Azure DevTools team. So I just took over the Bicep tooling ownership. We have very excited to share that we now have a extension for Visual Studio.
Awesome. And Bicep is such a great tool, and we're seeing it used more and more, especially because ARM templates were really a pain in the butt to use. And Bicep is fantastic, and it's really picking up momentum as new features have gotten released with it. So I'm really excited today. We're going to talk about VS Code and the Bicep extension. So take it away.
Yeah, sure. So in the past, we, as you say, right, April, Bicep, it's popular. We have a very strong community, and we have been hearing a lot of feedback from our community members. So they have been going to the Visual Studio Code extension because, you know, it's such a productivity improvement for folks, right? I mean, you have the Bicep compiler to help make sure that you're altering your Bicep file correctly. But the thing is, if let's say your primary editor is actually Visual Studio, you end up having to switch editor to go to Visual Studio when you need to edit your Bicep file. True. So we listened to our community and added the extension for Visual Studio.
Awesome. So that's great. Because yes, I do all my editing in VS Code, like all the time. And if I'm in a project that requires Visual Studio, I have to go back and forth, which is okay. But I don't get any of kind of the linting tools or anything else that I use with Bicep very, very heavily.
Yeah. So from Visual Studio 17.3 onwards, so 17.3 and higher, you actually get the extension. So yeah.
Awesome. Cool.
Well, so let's switch over and let me show you some of the demo.
Awesome. I can't wait.
All right. Okay. I am going to... first of all, I'll show you how to get the extension. You can go to the Visual Studio Marketplace. Okay, I do already have my extension installed, but you can search for it and look for Bicep. There you go.
Awesome. Easy to get to.
Yeah. All right. So with the Bicep extension, right? So I do have two parameters here that I have defined in a Bicep file. So as you can see immediately that in the error list, I have two warnings here. If I mouse over name, it's actually telling me information about param name. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I want to point out here, April, that we do support the Bicep config JSON. So you can actually update this. If I save this, right, and take note of the error list, if I save it, you can see that immediately it becomes error, right? Mm-hmm. And if I go back to the Bicep file, you can see the red squiggly line underneath.
Yes.
Yeah. So let me show you. All right. Suppose right now, if you, it's not just that, right? So you can actually explore, like, let's say, imagine that I want to insert a, declare a resource. So I am really, really bad at typing. So this is really helpful. See, I already mistyped that. And let's just go ahead and create a, add a storage account. And I can actually go ahead and select storage account here and allow me to explore the resource type that is available.
Yep.
And of course, there is also different versions, right? And I'm just going to select the latest version for this. And take required properties, right? So the best thing with the validation and because of the bicep compiler and everything, right? So I can go, oops, my bad. So I can go away, go ahead and update this to be name.
Mm-hmm.
Is update to be location. And instead of three, the linter is going to tell me that, oh, I can, this is actually the valid properties value that I can pick, and I can update this as a blob storage.
Cool. So I like that because you can actually, you know, the red squiggly lines, like my worst friend and my best friend at the same time when I'm writing bicep scripts, it tells me I did something wrong, but then I need to figure out where I did something wrong. So it's great that you can change that from a warning to an error because your script won't execute without that. Easy to fix, easy to see, and easy to parameterize your whole script.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Now, if let's say, now I know this is a very small bicep file, but imagine you have like a bigger file and you want to be able to look at the definition, right? You can actually right-click on look, the parameter, and you can actually pick definition. Okay, you can also go to the definition.
Yep.
And the best thing about this is you can actually do a rename, right? I mean, these are all the things that you can you expect in a VS Code extension. Perhaps what I do is I want to rename look to my look and it will be refactored.
I love that because I have definitely made changes to not all the correct parameters before or left an item somewhere that didn't get changed. So I love the ability to select all those occurrences of that item and change that. Yes. That's one of my favorites.
Yeah. So, and as you can see, once I click on name, it shows me all the highlight, where it's used, you know, all this. Yep. That's awesome. One more thing I want to show you is perhaps like, for instance, sometimes we want to deploy the bicep to the resource group location, right? The current resource group location. So we have the dot properties, right? And we can just select resource group locations to do that.
Awesome.
Yeah. Cool. So it doesn't end here. We also support CBIT.
Mm-hmm.
To say VNet. Let's say, suppose I want to insert VNet and I want to get a sample code. So I can insert the code snippets by just doing this, and the entire code snippets will be inserted.
Awesome. That was easy. That was probably the fastest and easiest way to write a bicep file, especially in Visual Studio. That's great. PC, thank you. That is really cool. I love seeing it in Visual Studio. It makes it a lot easier when we're doing our larger projects, especially when we're working in Visual Studio. That was such a long time coming for that extension.
Yeah, thank you, April. So not all the capability in Visual Studio Code extension is supported in Visual Studio yet. Mm-hmm. So we, as I said earlier, we listen to the community. So if there is anything that, oh, April, if like for instance, if there's anything that you are looking for, right, we listen to the community, go to the Bicep repo, and then either create an issues or give us an upload for any existing issues. So let us know.
And we'll put a link to that repo in the show description for everyone. So remember, if you don't see a feature, always give that feedback because PC and the whole team are listening. They want to know what features are important to you. I actually like the visualizer that you get in VS Code. So I can visualize what I'm going to deploy before I'm deploying it. I like pictures. It also gives me something to reference before I deploy it. So I'm a big fan of the visualizer. So I definitely vote for the visualizer. I'll go into the GitHub repo and submit that. But yeah, I think we'll put all the references for all the content, how to learn Bicep. We'll put a link for the extension in the description. And is there anything else that we need to tell everyone, PC?
That's it. We also have a monthly community call. So we will be sharing that link as well. So join the call and we would love to listen. And you will hear about new features and stuff like that. And we always love to get feedback from our customers.
Perfect. PC, thank you so much. We'll get everyone who's watching this video involved on that community call. We'll get them to give feedback in the GitHub repo. And for everyone out there watching, we'll put all the links in the description. Thank you for tuning into the DevOps Lab, and we'll see you next time.